Yeah.
And now, our feature presentation.
Thank you.
could do it better than Moses. Moses was unworthy. Because a few people in Moses' family began to accuse him. Moses wasn't worthy anymore. So up popped Korah. But God is not a fool. When God chooses a man, he chooses him. God don't say, uh-oh, I made a mistake. You go back, not the God of heaven. When God chooses a man, he chooses him for his total right. He knows everything that the man will do before it's done. And anything that the man does, God Almighty knows it, permits it, wills it, and backs it. But the fools don't understand, and they become corrupt in that which they don't understand. But Moses was God's man. And when old foolish Korah jumped up against Moses, God said, good. I want to prove that I'm with him. Anyway. You know, God likes to prove from time to time that he's with his man. That his man. There ain't nothing you can do against God's man. Some of you get jealous. As the people in Moses, they were filled with jealousy and envy. Everybody wanted to be a leader. Everybody wanted to be a big shot. Everybody wanted to say, God sent me, but you're nothing but a liar. You understand? God only sent one man at a time. One man at a time. And listen, wait a minute. And when God sent that man, then that's it. Every other black man or white man or red man, follow the man that God sent and don't give him no trouble. Or you die. With you then, because that's his name. It's been this way in the past, and that's the way it was in the time of Moses. Korah thought he was smart. So God shook the earth a little bit and killed him. And all those with him. And some more of them got smart. I want to see who you're getting this from. Produce him, Moses. Think about that. That's a heck of a thing, isn't it? Here's a man brought him through Egypt. Brought him into the wilderness. Guiding them. Nursing them. Then they got a nerve to tell Moses, look here, Moses. I mean, we had enough of you now. You dig? You're not sufficient anymore, Moses. You better bring us to the God that you've been telling us about. Take us up there right away. We want to see what it looked like. We want to hear him for ourselves. You've been telling us about it. We want to hear him for ourselves. That's in the Bible. That's in the Bible. Thank you, brother. Shoot. Moses, come on. After they kept persisting, he took them up in the mountain. And something happened. They went up in the mountain and the great explosion took place and Moses came down. And ain't nobody asked him ever since to show him where God was. No, sir. They got quiet after that. See, this is what God does for you. When you begin to disrespect his messenger, he'll make some examples for you. He'll kill off a few to let you know that that's the same thing that's going to happen to you when you turn against God's messenger. It is better for you not to ever have known the man than to know him and say you believe in him and turn your back on him. I said, death is the answer. Not for me, but God may speak through me. I just may be the instrument of God's judgment. I don't know, because all of us are his creatures. And he moves man to do his will at his command. Do, or have you do, or have somebody else do, or take an infidel and make them do, take an unbeliever and cause them to do, but his will be satisfied one way or another. All of you go bow down. Oh, baby, you got love. A man like Moses. God finally did drown Pharaoh, didn't he? Messed up his country, tore his country up, messed up his army. Kill Pharaoh. And according to the teachings of the Holy Quran, Pharaoh's body floated to the surface some years ago. And it is now entombed in the museum in Cairo, Egypt. And the Quran says that it was for a sign for governmental rulers, a sign for LBJ, a sign for Queen E, you know, Queenie. A sign for De Gaulle. A sign for NASA. A sign for Tony Lai. A sign for Castro. A sign for any leader. Any ruler. A sign for minister. A sign for captain. A sign for secretary. A sign for anybody that got authority over people that don't belong to you but belong to God. You better tread easy. You better walk like you know that these are God's people. You respect God, or otherwise God will bring you down to your knees in front of the very people that you threaten. And get away with it. If you get away face you before your fellow man. Hell was a sign for the nations of the earth, but the nations haven't learned their lesson. They think that when God sets examples before us, that God can't do it again. But he sets examples before you to show that whatever he did in the past, he's quite capable and quite powerful to do anything that he wills anytime he wills it. All praise is due to Allah. Pharaoh learned his lesson, and Pharaoh was set down in the history, in the Bible, and in the Quran, for government, for power, to be aware of. But ever since Pharaoh and Moses' emergence, think of it, Israel, that's who Moses taught. Please listen. He gave them rules and laws for their guidance because they were wicked people. They were savage people. They were an adulterous people. They were a thieving people. They were a covetous people. They were disrespectful people. They were quick to rise up to condemn constituted authority. So God gave them laws for guidance. God gave them laws for eating. God gave them a ruling scepter through Moses that they would rule the nations of the earth until God came. And God told them that if you rule this way, according to this law, you will have peace, abundance, joy. This is what he told Israel. Moses was hardly dead, brother, when the Jews began to rewrite Moses' teaching to suit themselves. God never wanted a man to enslave another man, whether it's a black man enslaving a man or a white man enslaving a man. No man is to be another man's master but God himself. I will never submit. Never. No more. I will not allow no man to master me but God and a messenger of God. Because a messenger of God and God himself are the only qualified beings for me to submit totally to. Because these men